Hi, I'm Spiro with SP Wood Art, and thank you very much for joining me here today. And I'd like to give a big shout out to everybody. Happy New Year. This is my first video of 2017, and I hope everybody's holidays went well. And I'd also like to give a big resounding thank you to all my new subscribers. Thank you very much for subscribing to my channel. I've had a pretty overwhelming response from my last video. So in this video, I'm going to turn a spoon and a spatula, and it's something that I've wanted to do for a while now, and today will be my first time trying it. So I hope you stick around to the very end and enjoy the show. Thank you. Perhaps the most important step of turning spatulas or spoons is aligning each end with the center of the handle. If you don't, you run the risk of not having enough material, say on one side of your spatula and too much on the other side, or the piece just comes out completely crooked. And the second most important piece of information, in my opinion, would be the wood selection. Some woods are toxic to certain people, especially to people with certain allergies. So I really wanted to put that out there, to be mindful of your wood selection when it pertains to food contact. Okay, I take it back. Selecting the wood is the most important step. Centering your spoon handles with the ends, or spatula handles with the ends, is now the second most important step. It creates a lot of wind. Anchor. Bevel. And I'm starting with light cuts in the beginning until it gets a little bit round, because there's a lot of air that's spinning and you could definitely get some bad catches if you push too far with the gouge. So I'm going to stop here on the spatula head. It's a pretty good width, and I don't want it to actually get any smaller. And don't mind those chatter lines. I'll clean them up later. I use this a lot on cutting boards, or I'll use this beekeeper's gold, which is pretty much a mixture of beeswax and mineral oil. And the other option is you can get some a block of beeswax. Smells great. And some mineral oil. You can make some yourself, or you could just use the beeswax.
So I chose to use the beekeeper's gold, which is a pretty good finish. No reason why. And I'll apply about 3 coats and burnish it a little on the lathe. And I left the neck where the handle meets the spatula a little thicker to give it some strength. Now I've chosen to use my angle grinder to carve out the bowl on the spoon, and you can use several methods, say wood carving or something else, but I wanted to make several of these spoons in the future, so I've decided to make a jig for it, which I started off by using the handle mounting holes. And I basically went from there and designed the rest of the jig based on things I had laying around my shop. The only parts that I purchased were the 2 bolts that screw into the handles holes here. And wow, is that a crude drawing. And I did have some difficulty finding the proper mounting bolts for my angle grinder. It had a empirical 20 pitch, which was very hard to find. So I ended up going with a 1.25 millimeter pitch bolt instead, and that worked well. So I took this 5/8 inch threaded rod and this 3/4 inch ionized aluminum tube and cut two equal pieces off of each. About 3 inches long for the aluminum and about 10 inches long for the threaded rod. Then I'll just clean up the ends of all four pieces and chamfer the edge of the threaded rod so that the nuts can fit on there better. And then I will deburr with this deburring tool the inside of the aluminum rods. And just a quick tip, I will clean up my sandpaper before I use wood again after using the metal. And this is a piece of scrap hard maple that I'm just cleaning up that I'm going to use to help mount the aluminum tubes. Next, I'm going to cut three equal pieces of pine or some scrap wood you can use to give the jig platform leverage to accommodate the bolts underneath and to accommodate the possibility of using clamps. So, here are all the parts for assembly. sometimes the wood will dictate the shape. I found a couple of little holes here that I'm going to need to turn down a little bit farther, so the handle may be a little bit thinner than the spatula, but probably not enough to notice. I'd also like to mention that you shouldn't be pushing very hard, especially when the diameter of the handle is getting smaller, because you could get a lot of vibration and flexing. You may notice that I've been tapering my handles smaller towards the head and larger towards the end, and that was intentional to give it more of a balanced feel in the hand.
Besides, I love olive wood. These came out really well. They're well balanced. They feel great in the hand. It'll keep you away from the heat on the stove. It's nice. They're about 14 inches long a piece. They're light and really strong. Here is my second set where I got a little bit artistic. I had some fun making some different shapes. I didn't show making these in the video, but I definitely would say practice makes perfect, because my second set came out more to the shape that I wanted. The jig worked great, although, you know, watch that you don't pinch yourself in here if you're going to make something like this. And the platform was nice because it's big, stable, and I can turn this around next time so the dust blows this way and make a dust shroud here, or make something where these poles can come over here and maybe this grinder could go sideways and I could make a metal cutting jig, and it's just be a multi-purpose angle cutting jig, which would be really cool.